seconds away on Studio 5.
You want to be here?
I want to be a singer, like Taylor Swift. Do you like Taylor Swift?
No.
The brothers behind this big screen, priceless story.
Mirror, mirror, mirror on the wall, telling those lies.
Grammy award-winning duo for King and Country are in Studio 5. Plus,
the Emmys were rigged again.
Should have gotten it.
We have your entertaining election results recovery guide when Studio 5 starts now. And welcome to Studio 5, where the good news today is we all survived the race for the White House. It is a great day to have some fun with the election results, no matter what side you're on. Well, now that you survived, we've got your 5 steps to election recovery a little bit later in the show. But first, here's our weekly look at what's new and now in the world of uplifting entertainment. This is your week's top 5 from Studio 5. Coming in at number 5.
5, 6, 7, 8, and sparkle, and sparkle, and spin.
A sneak peek at season 2 of Fuller House. Netflix released this trailer, and the countdown is on for the season's full release.
I just turned 60, and I just started thinking, what's it all about?
We're what it's all about.
Some 14 million people binge-watched the Fuller House first season, and they can look forward to Candace Cameron Bure and the entire gang's return December 9th.
This is going to be a tough play. Bryant, the Cubs!
The Chicago Cubs are still making headlines for their World Series win. President Obama has invited them to visit the White House before he leaves office. And a stage musical tribute to the baseball team is in the works, titled Miracles Do Happen. The play's been in the works since the baseball season opened and could include cameos by current Cubs players like MVP Ben Zobrist, who tweeted this after the win. Don't want to go to sleep yet. I'm still shocked. Thank you, Lord, for this special blessing.
When my emotions are kind of going crazy on me, or I'm caring a lot, or I'm thinking a lot about the game, the Lord has really helped me to separate it by showing me that my identity has nothing to do with what I do, whether I do good or bad. It has nothing to do with that. It's based on Christ.
By the way, some 40 million people watched the World Series this year.
Would y'all be cool if I open up with a prayer?
Gospel great Kirk Franklin comes in at number 3 this week.
La 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 la.
With this MTV documentary about the ups and downs of his life and music career, and much of the pain that came from the church.
I got a lot of criticism from a lot of Christians for working with Kanye. And a lot of people, you know, questioned my integrity, questioned my spirituality, you know, questioned my Christianity. It challenged me, you know, it is very painful.
Music and rising above church hurt are also our number 2 this week.
What am I listening to? I'm listening to Solange, Cranes in the Sky.
Christian hip-hop star Lecrae made his 3rd appearance on NBC's Tonight Show with Jimmy Fallon, appearing with singer Layla Hathaway.
All those feelings of depression and doubt, you gotta tell them go away.
And sharing his new single, Can't Stop Me Now. The lyrics, obviously, about rising above his recent battle with depression.
Last year I was feeling hopeless, I just wanted it to end. People stealing money from me, man, I swear I thought that we was friends.
At number 1 is a number 1.
Let there be light, open the eyes of the blind.
Hillsong Worship's new album, Let There Be Light, shot to number 1 on Billboard's Top Christian Album chart in its first week of release, selling more than 16,000 copies.
Jesus had no
This release marks the Australian band's 12th chart-topping project. And those are the week's top 5 from Studio 5. Luke and Joel Smallbone are brothers from Australia. They're best known as for King and Country, the Grammy award-winning Christian pop duo. The Busy Brothers are on the road for a holiday tour, but they made time to pay us a visit right here in Studio 5 to talk music, film, and even race in America. For King and Country, our this week's Studio 5 interview. Priceless, what inspired your involvement in this project?
Did I fail them?
There's no lock, huh?
Did I do what needed to be done?
Hey, the girls, where are you taking?
It's not your problem. Happy trails.
We went to our brother Ben just about 2 years ago, and he's a filmmaker. And we said, hey, I don't think we knew what we were asking at the time, you know, as often you don't when you start a new venture. We said, look, this has really resonated with our audience. Mm-hmm. What about taking this message to the silver screen?
Wow. And you executive producer and you acting.
Yeah. Yeah, it definitely was a family affair in the sense of obviously our older brother Ben directing it, mm-hmm. I'm being one of the producers, and then Joel saying, hey, you know what? I want to learn the American accent. I want to act. I want to be in this film. So it's been one of the most complicated projects that I've ever worked on, but yet I didn't have to do all the things that he had to do, so I can only imagine what he's thinking.
Luke thought about acting in it, though. You know, when we were growing up, we did all these short films, and Luke, for whatever reason, was always the first one to get killed off in the short films. So I think he was like, I don't want to die.
I never thought about acting die again. In this film. No. Let's get set the record straight.
It's a pretty gritty role for you, too.
Yeah, it was.
You obviously know something about this, then help me.
If you're hearing a little voice that's telling you to stay, that there's a larger hand at play here, then you might want to listen to that voice.
These girls don't belong to you.
Those girls don't belong to anyone.
You go down this road, you can't go back to normal life again.
There's some bad dudes who are going to kill you.
The reason that we wanted James to be an American, is we wanted him to be a normal person who is in this great country, who had just a tragic incident. He lost his wife in an accident. And how so quickly life can change, but also so quickly how you can find yourself in these sort of deplorable scenarios.
Sitting here with you and you saying that, it reminds me, you guys partnered with Lecrae for the song Messengers on his Anomaly album, just went gold.
It's your lie, 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 we know the time's running out, can't wait around, cause
we sent him the tracks. Lecrae put the rap on it. And it was like, well, and it worked beautifully, you know?
I met him after the song was done.
After the album was out.
So everybody would come up and do kind of like, hey, so how was it hanging out with your man Lecrae? I was like, well, after the fact, it was great.
Yeah. No, we love what they're doing. Actually, one of the guys on Reach Records, KB, who is, he's a great friend. We've toured with him. In fact, I remember well, it was right around Independence Day, mm-hmm. when that week, as far as the issues of these shootings and was just mm-hmm. horrific. Mm-hmm. And it was the Friday we had a show together, KB and us, and he was mm-hmm. joining us on stage. And we had probably a 2-hour conversation of just really getting down, as Australians coming into this, you know, mm-hmm. but getting down to like the heartbeat of what this is and different skin colors and different walks of life. And that was the beauty of it. We all came together mm-hmm. and we have to start. But what comes along with diversity mm-hmm. is you have to be deliberate in seeking understanding.
The Smallbone Brothers are part of a big and busy entertainment family. Those two fall in the middle of a family with 7 children. They're all talented. And Joel and Luke are sharing their singing talent right here on the Studio 5 stage. It's a priceless performance. Still ahead on Studio 5.
Can I mess your hair up?
A funny side to this election season. And 5 tips to survive the long-awaited results. Welcome back to the show. We've heard Luke and Joel share their story. Now it's time to sample the music sounds of For King and Country. Here they are in Studio 5 with Priceless.
Mirror, mirror, mirror on the wall, telling those lies, pointing at your flaws, that isn't who you are. that isn't who you are. Oh, it might be hard to hear, but let me tell you, dear, if you could see what I could see, I know you would believe that isn't who you are. There's more to who you are. Oh,
so when it's late, you went away, so much to take, and zones you never met me in the bed.
Priceless is also the name of For King and Country's book and movie. Both aim to remind women of their worth and encourage men to respect and honor them. Still ahead.
Hello. Who's this?
Congratulations. You're speaking to Donald Trump.
Comics love this election season. Studio 5's resident comedian has your funny five-step guide to recovering from the final results. Election day might be over, but conversations about America's new leader aren't dying down anytime soon. We don't usually talk about politics here on Studio 5. We're making an exception today to bring you this important and entertaining post-election public service announcement.
This is Molly. The candidate she voted for didn't win the election.
I just wasn't expecting a loss. I got a tattoo. And I just don't know how to face the future. I'm moving to Canada.
This is John. All I do is win, win, win. No, the candidate he supported did win.
Yeah, we won. Time to get the country back on the right track. At Molly Miller, bet you're regretting that tattoo. Hashtag sorry, not sorry. Hashtag oops. I knew my candidate would win. They were the right choice. The other candidate and their supporters were a joke.
Both John and Molly are suffering from a chronic disease sweeping the nation.
You know where our country is headed, right?
Post-election opinionitis.
We think post-election opinionitis has been around for centuries. We noticed in recent years, specifically in 2008, a huge spike in cases.
How can you make sure you don't fall victim to the disease? That's what we're talking about today in Studio 5.
Comedian Lionel Harris is here now with us, and we're talking about the five things you don't want to do now that the election is over. So what are the top five here?
Well, number five, which I think should be self-explanatory, but don't engage in political conversations today.
No.
That could be a bad move. Because most people don't even really know how to argue or debate properly. They don't know how to argue without emotion, right? So basically, if you go to work and you start a lot of political conversations today, you may end up in human resources doing some peer mediation before it's all over with. Just saying, play it safe is what I'm saying.
We don't want that.
No.
Now to number four. What's that?
Number four, this is what I guess millennials and maybe even some of the older crowd may like to do now as well, and that is venting on Facebook. Don't vent a long soliloquy on Facebook. Leave that alone.
Leave Facebook alone.
Yeah, that could be a... Facebook is the most contentious place on earth to begin with, particularly. And if you begin some arguments on Facebook, the argument could be about, I don't know, what place you like to eat at, but somehow the argument will always end up being racist. I don't know why that is, but Facebook always seems to go there.
Yeah.
So just leave that powdered keg alone. just don't do it.
All right, number three?
There's a 4B.
All right, so what's a 4B?
4B is don't vent with a short soliloquy on Twitter.
Okay.
Yeah, those 140 characters?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, like they could really ruin your life if you're not careful. I also want to say that you want to avoid all passive-aggressive memes and other forms of web mass
Twitter's
destruction.
Twitter's good for that.
yeah. You want to avoid all of that. Like, I mentioned the memes as well. Like, let's allow Kermit the Frog to finally finish his cup of tea. You know what I'm saying?
Yes,
he's been sipping on that tea for years now. And let's allow crying Michael Jordan to wipe his tears away. You know what I mean? He may need Restasis now. He can't even make tears anymore. He's been crying for so long.
Today would be a good day to do that.
Yeah.
All right, so we've got four, A and B. What about three?
Number three. Now, this one is a little awkward. If your candidate didn't win, the one you wanted to win, don't go congratulate a person who you think voted for the winning candidate.
Ooh.
Yeah, that's
a new one.
Yeah, well, that wasn't even a thing until 2008, noticed. What you would have is you would have droves of, and I hate to pick on them, but you'd have droves of white people congratulating the black community on the election of Barack Obama. And many of them may have been on Team McCain-Palin. They don't even know, and they wasted that congratulations. Mm. It doesn't really make you the bigger person. It just kind of makes you the dumber person, is what I'm saying. Don't do that.
Don't do that.
Avoid that.
Good.
All the way.
And now we get to number two. What is it?
Number two, if your candidate won, then the opposite. Don't go rub it in people's faces because they may punch you in yours, is number four. That's a long one. But essentially, you don't want to start beef. And the main reason being is that beef is delicious. You know, it's tasty. London broil, burgers, all of that is delicious. Somebody may cook you up and eat you. You know what I'm saying? So you want to keep all your conversations vegan or at least vegetarian out here, you know, for somebody.
So after the election, we're going to stay vegan or vegetarian.
That's right. You want to do that.
Probably gluten-free, too.
Yeah. You don't want to break out in hives, either, or make them. Well, you know, you get the idea. I don't need to elaborate.
Now, you have a number one.
I do.
You're going to save that, though.
Yes. I'm going to hold on to that.
He's going to hold on to that. He's going to bring it to us, though, for the final word. So make sure you stay with us, and we'll be right back with more of Studio 5. And we're going to get to the final word in just a moment. But first, here's a look at what we're working on for the next edition of Studio 5.
Right now, we are giving your problems an expiration date. And we're saying it's over. That you've been crying long enough. That you've been worried long enough.
There are reports that you threw her against a wall, hit her with a stool, threw her out of the house.
James Fortune,
went from Grammy-nominated gospel artist to jail time. He's opening up and owning up to the destructive choices that devastated his family.
Being abusive is a choice. It's not a mistake. It's something that you choose to do when you know it's wrong, and you do it anyway.
For today's final word, and also the number one thing you don't want to do after the election, comedian Lionel Harris is back again. So yes. What is number one?
Basically, number one is if you are a Christian, do not say that there was a clear biblical choice for a candidate, because people will be saying that on both sides, plus they'd both be wrong. Yeah, see, Jesus would be a Christocrat, not a Democrat. He would be a Lord of the men, not a Republican. You know what I'm saying? People have that mixed. And essentially, if you are all bent out of shape over an election and a political process, then it's just evidence that your focus is on man and on politics and not God to be your salvation. My question for you is, if God could save you and lead you with your mess and your craziness and your faults and your sins, why couldn't he do that for the person that he puts in office? Because to be exact, the Bible does say that God puts all leadership in place. So we should be praying for no matter who is in office. And I wrote this before, you know, today even got here. Right. And I don't even know, you know, didn't even know who won when I initially conceived this. But we should be doing that. Like, Christians need better PR. And this whole alliance with a political party or process is really damaging to the kingdom, I feel like. And essentially, in closing, if the greatest commandment is to love the Lord your God with all your heart, soul, and mind, and love your neighbor as yourself, and you can't show love to your neighbor because of a political affiliation, then it begs the question, do you love yourself? So my challenge is, love yourself so you can love others. Be salt and light instead of a bland, unpaid light bill, a.k.a. darkness. That's my final word.
I like it. I like it. We may have a new president, but there is only one true king, and that is the final word for this edition of Studio 5. Until next time, be sure to reach out and touch me at Ephraim Graham on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, as well as Snapchat, and then come on back and see where Studio 5 takes you next week. Bye-bye, everybody.